Cyclomatic complexity is a metric that tells you how many paths can your code take during execution. In combination with code coverage, it can help guide your coding and testing efforts. Code coverage, as its name implies, helps you increase the amount of code for which you have tests. With cyclomatic complexity, you can determine the exact number of tests that you need in order to increase that coverage. You can also avoid writing overlapping tests, which will keep the number of tests to a minimum. By knowing where your complexity lies, you can tackle those specific areas in order to make your code more maintainable and easier to change. To understand cyclomatic complexity, consider this method. Even if you're not familiar with the PHP language, you will still understand what's going on. The method always starts with a cyclomatic complexity of 1 because there is one execution path by default. We have an if statement. The program may or may not enter that code block. This means that there is one additional path, which adds 1 to our complexity. The next part is a loop. This is the same as an if statement, in the sense that the program may or may not enter that code block based on whether there are any elements in the array. That's one more path. Here we have an if, but with two expressions. Should be evaluated to false, the other expression will not be evaluated. We need to treat them as completely separate if statements. This means that there is a total complexity of 2 hiding within just this one line. Now there is code that catches exceptions. Each catch block is another path, since it executes only in case that specific exception type is thrown, so that adds 2 more to our complexity. We're up to 7. This means that we will need exactly 7 different test cases to cover all the lines of code in this method. I usually start with a default test that goes through all the code without entering any of the branches. Here we'll write a test in which A evaluates to false, so that the while block is skipped. The highlighted lines will be the only ones executed. We will then need to set up a second scenario where A would evaluate to true in order to enter this code block, but not inside the loop. The array should be empty for now. This way, we will execute all the lines inside the first if, but outside the loop. Now it's time to enter the loop. We set up an array containing items, but make sure not to enter the if block. Always write a test case to enter one block at a time. This will ensure that you don't write overlapping tests. Now about the array. I recommend entering it with 2 items instead of just 1. But why, you may ask? Here's an example loop. If we enter it with no items, the total will be 0 and our tests will pass. If we enter it with 1 item, the total will be taken from the item and we'd still have a passing test. However, if we enter it with 2 items, we'd hit a bug in the code, and our total would be overwritten. The simplest way to catch such bugs is to enter with 2 items instead of 1. Anything above 2 is unnecessary. Moving on to B or C. We'll write a first test where only C would evaluate it true and ensure that we enter the block. In the second test case, only B would evaluate it true, and would again ensure that we enter the block. The catch blocks are also straightforward. Set up your data in a way to cause an HTTP exception inside the try block, so that the associated catch is executed. And now set up your data in a way to cause an exception inside the try block, so that the second catch is executed. One last thing. You only test public methods of a class. If the public method calls any private methods, their execution paths are considered parts of the public method. So in this example, despite having an apparent complexity of only 1, this method really has a complexity of 3, since we added 2 from the private method and test everything together. And that's the end of the video. As always, support me on Patreon to help me create more videos. Thank you for watching and happy coding!